England players shaking hands in the background. They feel that the job is nearly done, and they've got a cracking player to come out next. Can this man stop him? Paul Hanvidge on stage waiting to go, but he's up against the man you saw win the Finland Open right here on Eurosport. Eurosport 2, Martin Atkins. What a great job he did, and we talked about it at the time, didn't we, Tony? We said if Martin Atkins can finally get the big title under his belt, there might be no stopping him.
Well, I saw him in the Lakeside Championships, and to be honest with you, he was outstanding for three sets against Barney. And I thought, what talent? And then it suddenly disappeared. And that's why one was in Finland, that I thought that Klassen, unless he really was on form, Atkins would take him and prove me right. But he's got a hard task here against the Scot, because Paul Hanvidge, one of the old stages, but he did very well. Very consistent player in the World Championships. Martin knows that. Two nice guys here. Let's say Martin from Yorkshire, another of the great talents Yorkshire produce. Paul, who comes from Renfrewshire. There it is, handshake. We're underway. Game on. One set away from a win. Can Atkins do it?
Could be a proud moment for Martin Atkins, and it could be another feather in the cap of what has so far been an excellent season for the Englishman. It was interesting talking to Tony David, my co-commentator at Lakeside here on Eurosport, when I said, you know, Atkins very often states how well he plays against the big names, and Tony David simply said no, what he wants to be talking about is how many tournaments he's won.
Well, it depends, really. I think you better take one at a time. Yeah, it's great to talk about him, but this is the calibre of this man, Atkins.
Great start against the left-handed Paul Hanvidge, Scotland, and Mike Veitch in particular, the captain, will be hoping that he doesn't get knocked off his stride. He's another experienced player who shouldn't be troubled by this big stage.
180, well, like I said, the win in Finland makes all the difference. He's left 95, he's only thrown 9 darts. So Paul, 60, already shell-shocked. Is that the wolf after the lamb?
I think it is.
Well, double 19 there, double 19. Can still go, get in that bed.
Out. Well, he'll be just a bit disappointed with that, Will Atkins. He would have liked a barnstorming start.
He could have gone for 6, double 16, actually.
Yeah. 38 then, still on his double 19s. Hanvidge, no out at all. But that's good. That'll do him a lot of good for the next leg. Double 19 then. Well, that's four darts at it. God, yeah.
No, he's made it very difficult with that first dart. Now it's a chance for the Scot to come into his own here. Treble 20. Still a chance. Treble 18, double 16. Oh, unlucky. Back to the 20s, though. Down for the 16s.
Good thinking from Hanvidge, but still that elusive double 19 for Atkins. He's had five goes at it, and on the sixth dart, he finds the bed. He blocked himself off, rather, on the last attempt to check out, but was allowed another chance by Hanvidge, and Martin Atkins gets it off to a good start for England. One love he leads, and England leading 6-4 in the match overall. But what a comeback from Hanvidge. Oh, was brave there, because the dart didn't look particularly safe.
Well, that's two 180s, one from each player. And the thing is, it's Paul's advantage of throwing first, so what a great start in this leg. Like I said, I don't think it's any walk over this. It was so consistent in January at the championships.
95! This is the thing, isn't it? The players understand just how good their opponents are. There's a lot of respect between the players. And when you come to this level, it doesn't matter what the world ranking is, you could lose. And if Atkins isn't on his best game, Hanvidge will take advantage, as he could do in this second leg.
Good marker.
60.
So chances now. And he hit one of those maximums. We've seen him hit so many times.
140.
That'll help. 176, only 10 points adrift.
Yeah, looking out for 166, so it's about putting himself in position. Atkins also not on an out, but keep pressure on Hanvidge here.
Well, it's a good leg for Scotland. No outshot, 176. And Paul on 44.
Spraying the lines a bit, Atkins. And that is not good at all. So this is pretty much free darts here for Hanvidge if he wants.
Man, the options was double 14. Let's go for them 16s. That's just nice finishing.
He's trying to do a classen, isn't he?
Treble 20 to leave 68. Treble 20. 68 left, still treble 20. Bit of pressure now applied.
Double 14, Hanvidge. Double 7. One more dart for it. And that's where the pressure comes in if you make your opponent finish. And sometimes they don't. Double 4, Atkins.
Yes,
got it. Well, Hanvidge is going to be absolutely kicking himself, Tony.
He played so well in that leg. Should have been all over. But one loose start, that's all it takes. And that's the quickness of a match changing in this sport. You know, any other sport, you've got time to sit back and relax at times. But not here. You're up there, you're on your own. You're playing for your country. You've got everything with you, and even the nerves.
Well, I quite like the way Atkins approached that last leg. He knew he was pretty much out of it and Hanvidge was away, but he kept playing at his own pace, fast, to the board, darts straight away, and that, I think, just upset Hanvidge a little.
Well, you're right, actually, but when you think about it, Martin, with the advantage of throw, he thinks, well, I can let this one go, but he didn't. He continued. Get the big, because it happens that way.
And I guess with a big win under your belt, you do look at the bigger picture all the time. He's doing exactly that. Another ton 40.
Well, it's looking grim for Scotland.
And it did look so exciting for them when we joined our live coverage here on Eurosport 2. The Scots, 55. Two legs down, back they came to tie it up at 4-all. And then since then, it's been England dominant. Scotland haven't taken a leg now for two matches.
Yes, 7 is the number England are looking for. And then it'll be the big one. England, Wales.
And it's been building for weeks.
Mind you, this one's not over yet. Let me go for treble 18 with this first start. Well, that's what's for treble 18, I promise you. We've got 61 left.
Quick check with the scorer.
Yeah, it'll be 61. 25 will do, or treble 15. It's treble 15, leaves double 8.
Great for Hanvidge.
It's on the 20s.
Certainly is. This one for the game, 20s, and he's got it. So double top for Hanvidge. How he wishes he could have finished that comfortably in the last leg. But one in the bag will do. And a little chat to himself as he comes round. He's taken it against the darts. He now has the darts. And really, advantage now with Hanvidge.
Yeah, it's all square except the scoreline because throwing first.
95!
Sean Greatbatch. They got some tall lads in this England team, haven't
they?
Yeah,
he's the tallest. He's Sean.
6'5".
Yeah, big lad.
45!
Atkins isn't small, though, either.
In actual fact, his mother's playing for Scotland. Sorry, Wales. Something Scotland. He hasn't been to Scotland. Has he? Yeah, she plays for Wales.
We saw a quick shot there of Waits, and just behind him, Steve Farmer, both of whom took their games 3-love. Very well played. But Hanvidge trying to stop the rot here against Martin Atkins for Scotland.
Yeah, one or two loose starts for Martin. A steady progression.
And Martin does have the darts in the last leg. But maybe that's where that confidence comes from. He's just trying to keep his rhythm.
This looks good for Scotland to level.
105.
Yeah. Leaves him 120, which is Shanghai on the 20s. I can't see much happening here. Even with 100, he can't have finish.
So Shanghai, treble 20, single 20, double top. Oh dear.
It is okay. 119. Step back. He knows he's going to be coming back, so he wants to set him up for a nice little finish for his next throw. So treble 20 would leave him double top.
24.
Oh, look at them loose darts.
Dear me, poor Hanvidge. Getting himself in a bit of a state on stage.
Well,
there.
It could be, because 180 here, or even 140.
100. Scotland required.
You saw it in Atkins' eyes, didn't you? He was after him then, but still got some work to do. So 95. That's better from Hanvidge.
Yeah.
Double eight
it's
gets
there.
It. I like it from Paul Hanvidge, because he's been under all sorts of pressure, and that is a great touch from Martin Atkins. Little shake of the hand before this deciding leg, and appreciation from Atkins that Hanvidge has hung around in this game. Now, can he find some form, and will Atkins' form to continue to desert him?
Well.
Oh, what a start. Well, when it comes to rugby, there's never really any debate about which nations wear their shirts proudest. But in darts, I think the Scots boys love it, don't they? They love pulling the shirt on.
Well, he looks as though he's taking the dog for a walk. He's so relaxed, is Paul. And he's taking this leg over. Come on, let's have a nine-dart finish, Paul.
Oh, no, yes.
You never know. You never know.
Oh, it's on. He's on. He's on for it.
It's on. He's certainly on for a win, but can he do a nine-dart finish? 52,000 would have been the prize money in the Lakeside World Championship.
I have to admit.
180's all over here. 141. Treble 20. No, it's not going to happen.
Dear.
Not going to happen, Simon. But still, he's still in a good position to take Scotland up to 6-5 against.
Would have been amazing. I have to admit, Tony, I'm a nine-dart virgin. That's a shame. Would have enjoyed seeing that, but 96 left.
Treble 20. Yeah, it's double 18. Double 9.
87.
Now then.
Oh, my goodness.
Now then, surely two maximums, and how's he going to lose a leg? Well, that's one. He can still go out. Treble 19, ball.
Just low. 40. So goes back to the 20s, and so it's still on. One double four. Double four it is. Just on the wire. Oh, someone thought he got it.
Yeah.
And it didn't put him off. Brilliantly played by Paul Hanvidge, because the shout from the crowd could have knocked him off his rhythm there, but he didn't let it happen. Put it away.